you know, he asked me what I did, and I told him, and he's like, Jesus, he's like, I've done a couple commercials before, man. It's like, how do you deal with those meetings, you know, the pre-pro meetings and stuff? That's so nerve-wracking. And
that's I just watched
this guy like risk his life, you know, climbing this event. And he's telling me he's scared of like having a meeting, you know, with suits.
Yeah. That's a big thing. I mean, people are listening to this and they're going to want to say, what's the dynamic of that? What are some of the bullet points that you could say that's like, because you've done it so many times and that's the part.
Yeah, I mean, that music videos then led to opportunities directing TV commercials, and that's primarily what I do now, although I am working on a long-form biopic show on a hip-hop artist.
What's the most difficult, real quick, though? I want to know, what's the most difficult commercial you ever worked on?
Difficult. I mean, it's got to be stuff. I've worked in Russia a bunch, and just the language barrier, the logic barrier, working there, you know.
Still stigma in Hollywood? Because I know you want to break into features, right? Is there still stigma? So like this guy, we talked, and you know, Peter Gerber, I sat with him in a room, and he actually told a commercial director, I like commercial directors because they know how to do, you know, the beginning, middle, end of, you know, productions. They have to tell a lot of information in a short amount of time. Everything's condensed. You know, there's a lot of, that's why commercials pay so well for, you know, the crew that's on there. You have the best of the best and they know how to, you know, do a lot. I mean, is there a stigma to that still to get over to the next level, or what's the dynamic of that right now?
I don't think so. I mean, that's good to know that Peter Gerber said that. Maybe you can introduce me to him after.
I haven't talked to him in a while. We're supposed to get him on the show.
Yeah, I don't think so. I think a lot of people have had success. I mean, I have had problems going into the documentary field just because, you know, I would have sort of, I never took the leap and like finance my own doc and like you did and, you know, just went after some subject material. I had docu-style stuff in some of the commercials I did, some of the more long-form branded content stuff, but it just never translated. I've had lots of opportunities, but people were like, oh, you don't have the experience. And finally, this time, a friend went to bat for me.
To do what you do, though, to have the kind of career that you've had consistently, you know, that's why I did documentaries, and it's kind of like me being an entrepreneur. I'm an entrepreneur because no one would hire me. I did documentaries on my own because I could never do the dynamic. You know, there's a political and a skill set for you to get each job and prove yourself. You know, your resume proves. You know, I'm sure there's certain jobs you get. They're just like, hey, you got the green light already. But can you just talk about the dynamics of you going through that process of getting the job, you know, convincing whether it's a production company or the agency, you know, as far as commercials are concerned, or, you know, the music video. What are some of the dynamics of that? You know, somebody's trying to break into this business. What are some of the things you need to do X, Y, and Z? And if you don't, you better learn how to do it.
Yeah. I mean, that's a big part of it, you know. With commercials, typically the agency have already sold an idea to the client, you know, and they have a script and then they send it out to typically three different directors and then you give your approach to it. So there's, you would do a call where you kind of pitch your idea, then you compile that into a treatment, like couple page treatment. And then on top of that, your production company that you're working with submits a budget. So it's like a combination of those factors plus your past work that will all lead to whether or not you get the job. So,
I worked on a lot of commercials and I have the director, we talked about this, Christopher Guest, you know, having problems with the agency saying, well, you know, the creative, you know, they're saying, well, we have this idea. And he's like, oh my God, if Christopher Guest is going through problems with this, because to me, he's an amazing, you know, auteur, you know, if he's going through that stuff, it's like, how do you handle, have you had run into sometimes where you got to compromise with the agency as you're shooting?
Yeah, all the time. But that's funny. That reminds me of a story, a funny thing that happened to me. I had dinner with a bunch of people. I was sitting next to Jimmy Chin. you know, he's a filmmaker, did the movie about the free climber, that didn't it win the Oscar.
Yeah.
What's the name of that movie?
I know. Yeah, it was great. Yeah. It came out like a couple years ago.
Yeah. Yeah. And he did another movie that was equally as insane about these climbers trying to climb this peak, one of which he was the climber. He was climbing with them and filming them. Meru, I think it's called Meru. It's this impossible peak. And I had watched it the night before. I sat next to him at dinner and you know, he asked me what I did and I told him and he's like, Jesus, he's like, I've done a couple commercials before, man. It's like, how do you deal with those meetings, you know, the pre-pro meetings and stuff? That's so nerve wracking. And
that's what I want to talk about.
Watch this guy like risk his life, you know, climbing this event. And he's telling me he's scared of like having a meeting, you know, with suits.
Yeah. That's a big thing. I mean, people are listening to this and they're going to want to say, what's the dynamic of that? What are some of the bullet points that you could say those, like, because you've done it so many times. Mm-hmm. And that's the part.